Welcome, Gators, to GVTV.
Good morning, Gators. I'm Andre Rubio.
And I'm Kristen Strahler. Let's go to Sion for this week's announcements.
Good morning, Gators. I'm Sion West, and this is this morning's announcements. Today's weekly success goal is you've got to take the initiative and play your game. In a decisive set, confidence is the difference. Students, if you need assistance, check out the College and Career Center in the library. Chance members, there is a meeting after school today. Gators, are you dreaming of some hot chocolate? Well, the time has come. Starting November 30th, we will be selling Dunkin' Donuts hot chocolate every Thursday and Friday until winter break, only $1. There is a home flag football game today at 3:30 against Sierra Vista. Wrestling is participating in the Green Valley Duels this Friday and Saturday in the Green Valley Gym. See you there. Well, that's it for the announcements. Now back to Kristen and Andre.
There's talented students all over the school.
Let's check out Gatortainment with Jake and Jade.
How did you guys get started?
Freshman year, me and Shaq just kind of started hanging out, and he invited me to his birthday party, and all we really knew about each other was that we both played instruments. He played bass and I played guitar. Yeah, we didn't have Ruben yet, but yeah, at the time. So he invited me over to his birthday party freshman year, and we kind of jammed a little bit. But he had a drum set too, so he showed me his skills, and I was like, dude, what are you doing playing bass when you can shred on drums like that?
How did you come up with the name of your band?
Homecoming, sophomore year. Me and Ruben were kind of hanging out after the dance, and I was like, dude, wouldn't Full-Fledged be an awesome name for a band? He was like, yeah, man, it'd be so cool. Remember, you sounded just like that, Ruben.
Yeah, I was just like, dude, yeah, let's do it.
And Shaq just kind of liked it in the end. I think, what were our names before that? We had, like, Harakiri.
And we decided on Spirit Detach with 2 exclamation points.
Exclamation points!
It's Nick and Greg time.
I wonder what kind of shenanigans they're up to today.
Sprite shots fall.
Man.
Sprite shots fall. Yes. Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall.
Oh, almost.
Sprite shots fall.
Oh, he knew it was coming.
Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall. Oh. Sprite shots fall.
Ow.
Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall.
Oh, no.
Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall.
Sprite shots fall. Ow.
Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall.
Ow.
Sprite shots fall.
Oh.
Sprite shots fall.
Let me help you out.
Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall. Sprite shots fall.
Are you good? That's Sprite shots fall.
Hey Gators, we're gonna find out what you're thankful for.
I'm thankful for a great family, great friends, working here, a great partner.
I'm grateful for my parents, my friends, and just my interests and what I like. It pushes me to do what I want.
I'm thankful for everything that like the church gave me, for my house, the schools, everything pretty much.
I'm most thankful for my family.
I'm thankful for my belt so my pants don't fall.
I am thankful for my family and for life.
Let's see what you know with Uriah, Nathan, and Santino.
How many sides are in a heptagon?
Seven.
Seven.
Like six. I don't know, six.
Seven?
How many staircases are in the school?
I'd say maybe like eight.
Seven, eight?
Do you mean the ones that are inside and they go up? Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At least six. Eight. I'm gonna go with eight.
What's the principal's name?
Jeff Horn.
Mr. Ross or something.
The horn.
Mr. Goldberg, right?
What's bigger, an oval or a circle?
An oval.
Oh, yeah, an oval. Can it be an oval? Yeah, I said, right?
A circle. Well, you could have a big circle and a small oval. It would just depend.
How many stripes are on the American flag?
13.
13.
Yeah, 13.
Am I right?
13.
13 plus.
Get ready for Fine Arts Week.
Hello, I'm Marcus Cooper, and I'm here with Miss K, band director of Green Valley, and we will be interviewing her about the importance of Fine Arts Day. And why do we celebrate Fine Arts Day?
Well, because when we're educating young people, we want to make sure that we're giving them the whole package. So they get to do academics, they have athletics, and here we're honoring those students that have an affinity for the arts.
And do all schools have Fine Arts Day?
No, not all of them, but we hope they all will someday, but there are many that do.
Bye, Gators. Hope you have a good Fine Arts Week.
Ever feel like someone's watching you?
Welcome to Gator Planet. Today, we'll be studying the habits of the elusive teenager. Here we have them in a library, performing the awkward ritual of studying. This one sits reading intently, not paying any attention to the world surrounding him. As they walk to school, notice how lethargic the majority of the pack is. In their classroom, how comfortable and safe they seem. Notice how they grouped in packs, although some walk by themselves. Thank you for watching. This is Gator Planet, stalking in the halls.
Well, that was creepy.
Anyways, it's time for Gator Center.
Good morning, Gators, and this is Gator Center. This week, we interviewed Coach Ferry of wrestling and Coach Jarvis of basketball. Let's go back and see what they said. Coach, what is your strengths as a team?
Our strength as a team is we're very deep. We've got very high-quality number one guys and high-quality number two guys, which makes our team very deep and hard to compete with.
And, Coach, do you have any returning players from last year?
Yes, we do. We had 9 state placers out of 14 weight classes last year, and we return all 9 with some very nice incoming freshmen to help build that depth that we've already have.
That's great. And Coach, what is your outlook on this year's team?
Our outlook this year and every year is to first and foremost win our division, second win the regional tournament, and be fortunate enough to be able to put ourselves in a position to repeat as team state champions.
Well, thanks, Coach.
Last year was a great year. We went to state. We won our regional championship for the first time since 1994. So it was an awesome year last year.
Actually, our goal is always to win state. So this year we're motivated. We're excited about a new year. We want to complete our journey. Last year we lost by 2 points in the state game. We want to go back there this year and win.
In their first ever debut of women's flag football, they annihilated Del Sol 40-13 in a very physical game.
Damn, go, 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 go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go,
Leanna, Mercedes, Abigail, and Anthony have this month's Teacher of the Month.
Hi, I'm Anthony Snow, and I'm interviewing Mr. Draculitz, November's Teacher of the Month. So, Mr. D, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm Mr. Draculitz. I have a wife and 2 kids, and we love to go camping and in our free time, and I spend a lot of time here preparing for my students.
So, what inspired you to be a woodshop teacher?
I was a carpenter for the Clark County School District, and some people around me started telling me that I might have the opportunity to teach with the right, taking the right classes. So we did some research and figured it out, and now I'm here teaching.
So how long have you been a woodshop teacher at Green Valley High School?
I've been teaching here this is my third year, and I've enjoyed it ever since I've gotten here.
Thank you, Mr. D. Now back to Christian and Andre.
Christian has an alumni spotlight on Raul Medina.
What's up, Gators? My name is Christian, and this is an alumni spotlight with Raul Medina. So what year did you graduate, Raul?
I graduated from Green Valley High School in 2005.
So what did you do in Green Valley? Any sports or something like that?
Yeah, I played varsity soccer all 4 years.
So what did you do after high school, after you graduated Green Valley?
Right out of high school, I got a scholarship to play at a junior college in Northern California, in Susanville, California. I played one season, and in one of my last games, I tore my ACL.
So did your injury ever affect you?
My injury, yes. My injury slowed down my momentum. I was in the process of trying out for a professional indoor team, the Las Vegas Knights. And it put me on a little setback, but on December 8th, I have my first tryout for a brand new indoor team, the Las Vegas Dust Devils.
So thank you all for your time. Good luck in your tryouts. So back to you in the studio.
This month was the Fall Sports Banquet. Crystal has more information.
Good morning, Gators. This is Mr. Scott. I just wanted to tell you a little bit about our Sports Awards Banquet. It started about 5 years ago, where we wanted to get all the sports together to see the accomplishments each sport has accomplished. I wanted all the athletes to see athletes from different sports, not just their own sport. They sometimes get caught in their own little world and just stay in their own football world or volleyball world. And then at the end of the season, this culminating activity shows the other sports that there are other athletes here at this school, and that there are academic all-state athletes in different sports. There are kids earning scholarships in different sports, and it's the same kids you're walking the hallways with every single day. That just because they don't play football, they do exist here at school. And just because they play volleyball, they're not just a volleyball player, they're a student. And I want them to see all the other activities that go on at Green Valley High School.
Congratulations to all the students for earning a varsity letter in all 4 years in their sport. Tyler Fayette from cross country, Jacob Johnson, Isaac Willis, Alejandre Oliveira from men's tennis, Ricardo Goodlow, Brian Ball from men's soccer, Alexandra Cowie and Sarah Thomas from women's golf, Nicole Westover from women's soccer, Jenna Swaffer and Carly Sheese from women's volleyball. Congratulations to Nevada All-State Academic Team athletes Robert Lovely and Alyssa Timpson from cross country, Amar Shaw, Noah Yaffe, Paola Davila, Ellie Johnson from tennis, Kimberly Bowers, Sarah Thomas from golf, Nathan Hansen, Alexander Stransky from soccer, and Tyler Toffin from football.
That's all for this week. I'm Andre Rubio.
And I'm Kristen Strahler. See you next time, Gators.